I should play with him like every time. You're taking advantage of your flat chest. She always wants something. If she's like that, that means she wants something. What the fuck does game have with people jumping from roofs? Just this music makes me tearing up, you know? Hello and welcome, Pocket Watch here, and it's about time for another episode of Little Busters. Yeah, I took a little bit of break, and I feel okay. So, let's just continue the story, and I hope we can go for a longer period of time now. Yeah. Last time we got into this situation. If you remember, if you don't remember what it was, basically we found a cat in a drawer with like brooms and everything. And yeah, we need to like destruct glass because everything happened bad. So last time we said that we are swinging out the equipment, which was making a lot of sense. So now, let's just be a little bit of crazy. Yeah, let's be a crazy guy. And let's say, this is my home. I can do whatever I want. Let's do that. I'm home! I walked in and closed the door. It really is best to relax at home. Don't worry about that, do your thing. I got out. What the heck was that? Everyone went, huh? So, is that where Noah lives? And went back to what they were doing. Nice thought, Nikki. It feels like a lot of people were looking at me with pity. What they did? I don't remember. Oh yeah, okay. And they like grab her. Yeah, okay. Let's see, what did you consider? Pop quiz. Kurugazaya-san. Oh yeah, she's like skipping the math class. Yeah, I considered Fyodor. It's Kurugaya-san we're talking about. I'm sure she knows how to handle the situation with a problem. Without a problem. When I thought about it like this, how should I put it? Kurugaya-san sure relies her freedom. It's like she's detached from the world. Yep. I was thinking about how she never attends math, but she's still fine. Yeah, well, she's skipping a class, but she's still the best. I assume that By the way, I assume that their class doesn't care much if you're skipping class, I would say. Unless Kurugaya have like special treatment. Yeah, well. Oh, wow, okay. Is she really that smart? Yeah, okay, makes sense, like, really. But, you know, some schools have these rules that you have to attend to certain percentage of classes to basically pass. And seems like that's not the case for everyone, or not for the school. Probably not the case for Kurugaya, just for her. She does attend other classes, but never math. Well, she's a genius, so that must be something common people like me cannot grasp. And why is she in a normal school such as this in the first place, if she's so smart? I mean, I don't know, smart people are in the normal schools, what do you mean? That's kinda a weird question for me. I mean, this school is... I don't know. I'm not going to talk about that. Break time! Are we going to meet like Komari here? Is it this one? No. Maybe? Oh, okay. You know what we're going to do. You know what we are going to do. Rewind that a little bit. And now it's time. It's time to summon the god of muscles, Masato-sama. Masato isn't here, so I can't play. I should go back to the classroom. God damn it! They got me. What should I do? I ran out of ideas to fool around with Masato. Why do we have sad song? I will have to replay the game. I just didn't record the footage. So, if game is off sync to this point, then that means, yeah, you know why. Also, I will cut here because I want to sync this part at least, so it's not going to be messed up, okay? So, be right back. Okay, I'm back. I also have a feeling like I know how I will edit this video out, so we can steal my camera during the past. Like, before this point? I'm not sure yet, but I will try to figure this out. It will be kinda pain in the ass, to be honest. Great way to come back to YouTube, yay! Let's go! Also, this is sad music, like I said before. Like, what the hell? There he is! Waiting for me. Are we having... Masato Road, I think. I don't know if it exists, but... what should I do? I'm pathetic. Someone patted me on the shoulder. Of course. It was Masato. Masato! Yeah.
New
power! Woo! Muscles! Muscles!
Kinniku!
I fooled around with Masato once again. That was great. I should play with him like every time. I think I did. I'm not sure. Did I play it with him every time? In this playthrough? Maybe not. No, I didn't. Because one time I played with him during the first playthrough. God damn it. I wonder if there's like some road with him if I like only play with him all the time. That would be like hilarious. I wonder where it would like end up. We are like going to the gym or something. Whew, that was fun. Yep. Yep.
Riki.
What?
お前にこれやるぜ.
He carefully passed me something. What could it be? Iron dumbbell. Hell yeah. We are going to be strong. During our next... Oh, that never happened before. Too many accessories, get rid of something. Oh, that happened before, but I never, like, get rid of something. I will take this out. I feel like wrist weight will be better. Also, it was also a present from Masato, isn't it? Let's go with this. Lunch break! Okay! And now we have to go for look for members. Oh no, we don't have to look. Wait, what? Cafeteria? Oh! Okay, so this is a question from Masato if we are going with him. So last time we got to the backyard and we met Kurugaya, I think. Kurugaya or Mio, I never remember, like, backyard, which one was it? Is it the part where Mio is sitting with her book and, like, umbrella? Or this is where we met Kurugaya? So, I will go to cafeteria anyway with Masato. I mean, I think we are pretty much dedicated at this point. God damn it, this episode would be great. But not the first part. God damn it. I'm so mad at me. I hope this part is recording properly though. Because if not, I will have to replay this. A whole hour listening to my voice and trying to sync this thing up. And this is a torture. Yeah, let's go, Masato.
Nori nori da na, Riki.
Fight on!
Shapaps!
If you fight 100 times, you'll die of exhaustion.
Oh, tsukkomi mo saewatatteru na. Sugoi ze, Riki-san yo.
Went to the cafeteria, making lots of noise along the way. He's great.
Maki.
We sat down around the table, which was empty for some reason. What he held out looked like a ticket. Huh? What's that? I took it from him to say what it was about. Coupon for 500 yen bread, it read. What's up with this? Kengo answered. The store coupon, huh? How did you get that?
Kobai wagon wo tori kakattara, 3 nen ga 2 nen wo osinokete ita.
Sure enough, there's sometimes a 30 years like that. Getting the store card always involves some competition, so when their upperclassmen mix in as well, some students feel intimidated.
So itsu ra wo hippegashitari shiteita koto ga suukai attanda ga.
Of course, after dealing with the 30 years, he would probably just leave without saying anything. That might be one reason why Kengo wasn't only respected by his club underclassmen, but the other students as well. That's cool. I see. I heard that members of student council were using these, but this is the first time I've seen one with my own eyes. So this is the legendary ticket that no one else have. God damn it, that's premium.
But, well, one person eating a pan is what it is.
What
do you mean? Realized what Kyosuke's planning and struck defensive stance. Oh my god, you mean like Rin is very like small and tender? I mean, small and slim, and she can like pass everyone, also she's a girl, so they won't hit her? Wait, what? You're taking advantage of your flat chest! Hell yeah, infiltration. Let's go, Mission Impossible. He handed her the usual hands-free set. That's a new kind of mission, we never had that before. This is awesome. I'm excited. Yeah! New mission! Infiltration mission. Who will start? He was waiting for the right moment. She thrust out her hand. Rain got hand on loaf of bread. Okay. Okay. So they're basically choosing at random. Great. Who's next? Yakult. I have no idea what the Yakult is. You can let me know in the comments. Drink it. So this is some kind of drink. What the fuck? What? Who cares? We exchanged glasses with Kengo. Hoo-hoo! Okay, this is a problematic choice, you know why? Because I have no idea how to read that. What I mean? We exchanged glasses with Kengo, and now, does it mean that go first, like, I'm telling him, go first. Or I'm going to tell him, go last. Or this is me, I go first, or I go last. I mean, I don't really care if I'm last. Also, Kengo is having a ticket, right? I will go last. I hope this is because this is like we going last. So I'll go last. I want to see what Kengo gets. Also, I am a nice guy. I was an asshole in this playthrough for like 3 episodes in a row. Or 2. I don't remember anymore. And I don't want to be asshole all the time, so I will just let him go first. I hope this is the right choice. Yes, okay. That one.
Mieta. Imada.
Nani ko te ni ireta?
Cabbage butterfly. What the fuck?
Omae, hana batake demo mieta no kai?
What is happening? Didn't you feel sorry for it? Let it go. Okay. Oh, poor Kengo, he got nothing. And I'm the only one left. I was waiting for the right moment. Wait, what the hell am I doing? Rin? No! Barium, I have no idea what that is. You can let me know in the comments. Oh, this is item. I mean, we'll get a breed of wrist whites. Why not? Wow, what the heck is that? Just because it's liquid doesn't make it drinkable. I want to. We are not conducting an experiment here. Yeah. Oh, that mission failed.
Rin, omae ima nani kakushita?
Masato noticed something. She got what she wanted. Give it to us. Also, my cat is doing this all the time. I have 2 cats and one of them is all the time like this. I mean, it doesn't like hurt you, but she don't like being like touched or anything. And the second one is like really liking to cuddle and everything, you know. Oh dear.
Koitsu, nanka hitori dake ii mono totte kiyagatta nda.
Omae ra no wa sore da. Kore wa atashi no da.
Why didn't you choose for us something good? I shot a glance at what Rin was holding behind her back. From this angle, I had a clear view of it. It was a bag of cup jelly. That's too big. Masato presented me his loaf of bread. Don't have anything to pull on it? That's a bit hard. Even though I said this, he looked so pained that I decided to give him a hand.
Hey guys!
Haruka used English.
Hey guys!
Wow, and her English is way better than Kud's. I choked when something suddenly hit me on the back. Haruka-san? Yeah, kinda. Kengo knitted his brows slightly. He was always calling Haruka-san the noisy girl, and didn't seem to want anything to do with her. However, he didn't say a word. So long as they didn't do something too outrageous, he was quite tolerant of my friends. That's random. What do you want? That's my question. She always wants something. If she's like that, that means she wants something. I remember there was one time, maybe this is the situation, when she forgot basically her food. And she wanted some food from us in the cafeteria. It might be the same thing, but like in different place. I mean different time, because last time we didn't had like this bread situation. Yeah. She greeted everyone as cheerfully as ever. The way she was waving left hand while speaking made her greeting seem completely superficial. Oh, I'll just help him. I was eating the bread as well since a while ago, but it didn't seem to have shrunk at all. She told a girl sitting nearby and pulled a chair next to her over to our table. I love smug Haruka. I still don't think she's like a good girlfriend material. Maybe she would be, maybe not. I don't know. Well, she's fun to be around with, I guess. As I said many times, she's like female Masato version. She's crazy. And kinda dumb. And kinda smart at the same time. And smug as hell. This is the best face in the game.
それから牛乳を飲むとプリンみたいに感じられるよ。
Okay.
マジか。マジマジ。うん、プリン。あれ？本当だ。こいつはプリンだぜ。
Damn. She's good. アホだろ。
騙されてるぞ、お前。
They butt in. Everything is in your head. Just think this is something different so we can eat it.
どう違ってくるんだよ。思い込む対象によるか。じゃあ、カツサンド。
She took a handkerchief from somewhere and was waving it before Masato's eyes. It was a black and white striped handkerchief. Okay. Masato is so easy to get manipulated by anything, pretty much. But how? Sorry. Putting that aside, did you come here for a reason? I asked Haruka-san as she was munching on some bread crust. Yeah, she was hungry.
Masato-kun からかうのが面白かったからつい。
お前男だったら爆死してるところだぜ。
What if you really kill someone with a bomb?
ベルマークもらおうかなと。
Wait, what? What do you mean? She told us her purpose. Bell marks.
ほら、購買部の紙パック牛乳とかパンのシールについてるじゃない。
Oh, so this is like stickers. So she can like get something from the shop of this. Like, I don't know, free meal or free drink, something like that. Sure, but why are you doing that? Oh, okay. I think she just want to make a boom out of this and a hit, because she's just like, maybe? Why are you asking? That sure takes me back. She was swirling a small purse around on a string. When I was in elementary school, I had to collect them too, bell marks that is. She held out her hand toward my milk carton. Masato suddenly interrupted. Wow, we have really choice between Haruka and Masato. Holy shit. I mean, Haruka is fun either way. Like, whatever, like when she is like nearby, she's fun. And I'm kinda committed to Masato. I had really a lot of fun with him lately. So I will go with Masato this time. That would probably like push her road maybe? I don't know, maybe something would happen, but I feel like I just want to like stick with my friend who was hurt, whose heart was bruised, who was fooled, and I need to stand by him. I need to help him. Now he's helping me. Let's go. It can be helped. I'm sorry, Haruka-san, but Masato is looking so pitiful that... Yeah, do that. This is the sign of our friendship. It would be creepy if you treasured it that much. Yeah, I'll be collecting them from now on, so okay. Great. That's cool. I like it. Shh, and she left. Pretty much. Indeed. When it came to lack of common sense, she was standing on equal footing with Kurogaya-san and Rin. Even, I would say even more. She's always doing the oddest things. But I wonder why I'm alone surrounded by this sort of girls. I couldn't help but wonder about it. Yeah. Also, there's Kud, but she's nowhere to be seen lately. Would have been an asshole to her. I'm sad. The speaker turned, making a hissing noise. And? All students must return to their classrooms at once and wait there. A teacher was informed. Why there's no sound? It became noisy in the classroom. Why we have again sad music? What the hell is happening in this game? Second time in this episode. Two of my students hurriedly rushed back into the classroom. What the fuck does game have with people jumping from roofs? Kudro had her parents. Well, not by their own will, but what the fuck? No way this is happening. No way. No. This is too early. She exclaimed. Upon hearing this name, the one all of us turned, it was obvious. Obviously, Kingo. She's on the rooftop, and there was the broadcast. It must be something serious. So tell us. Why they're so calm? What the fuck? Like, I would say that I was thinking that Kengo would just rush through the door. Kyosuke was standing behind us. What's going on? And she feels like she has no purpose in her life anymore. What the fuck? I was fooling around in this episode and suddenly it got freaking heavy. This is weird. He's too calm for this. I feel genuinely weird by this conversation. Because how he calmly explains that. Huh? Does that mean she's trying to kill herself? Maybe for you. What the fuck? Don't do that. Don't do that, like, ever. Like, no one wants that. Anyway, let's search for her. We have to help her, don't we? Kengo? He didn't leave his seat. He was looking emotionless, like always. But perhaps he was feeling full of regret on the inside. The one she was always consulted was Kengo. Maybe there was something more that he could have said to her. I felt that he was regretting this. Kengo. I said his name one more time. But he didn't budge. Kyosuke urged us on. Masato rushed into the corridor. Kyosuke followed after him. What is his choice? Wow, I didn't expect that. I really did not expect this turn of events. To be honest, both answers can be bad. Both answers can go wrong. If we press can go on, we may be late. We might not get there on time. And if I chase after Kyosuke, we might not be able to do anything. Because Kengo is probably the only person she would listen to. So I think the best choice is to press Kengo. Because there's a chance that we might still get in time. But we can't do anything without him. That's what I think so I will press can go on and try to get him up as soon as possible. We need to figure it out before going to her. She's too desperate to listen to anyone else. She always consulted you, didn't she? If you don't come to her now, when will you? Why aren't you saying anything? There's no one else who can save her as she is now but you, you know? Yeah. Ah, you're annoying. Come on, get to your feet. I grabbed his hand, and he finally responded. The air trembled because of his loud voice. The noise inside the classroom died down. He brushed my hand off and pointed at the ceiling. Huh? What do you mean? Perhaps to drive students away, there was a teacher standing at the foot of the stairway. He was the counselor of the Kendo Club and had a harsh personality, never showing any mercy to those who disrupted the order. Just as he spotted us, he rushed to drive us away.
Oyo.
Wow. We're using force. Okay, Masato, it's your time to shine, I guess. Masato cracked his fists as he drew closer to the teacher. The difference between their body frames was too much. Regardless, the teacher didn't move an inch, facing Masato. I probably should have said that's expected of Kendo Club Consular, but Masato sent him flying down the stairway in no time.
Okay.
He will so get mad at us. What is this episode? Wait. I just realized I don't have date in the corner. Does that mean that I'm on some kind of road? I hope I will figure out what kind of road I am before I upload this episode. So I can make like a special thumbnail. Unless this is just... I don't know. The teachers were gathered up on the roof. Almost every teacher was probably called out there. They were standing with their backs to us. It was a bizarre scene. Nobody took notice of our intrusion. And their gazes were fixed on one point. The one girl who was standing on the other side of the fence with an eye patch that made her look so miserable. Koshiki-san. Yeah, that's a fucking problem. I mean, it's not necessary being not serious. Also, what Kengo meant by this is under control? Like, what the fuck? What do you mean? But it didn't seem that she would go back so simply. What good will it do if you fall into despair at this point? There's still a lot that you can do. They just were lecturing me one after another, but she showed no reaction to their words. Lecturing her, okay. She was only shaking her head. You're wrong. Nobody could understand her. What is it that could reach her heart now? Something that Kengo, I know, couldn't do. There was no way those adults would be able to do something about that. What do you have? She curled up, as if protecting herself from the eastern wind, and clutched the fence. From that edge, that was out of her line of vision, a teacher was slowly drawing closer. Oh my god. Kyosuke looked up at the sky. Huh? As being provoked by the wind, Koshiki-san turned around. Her eyes opened wide. She opened her mouth and screamed something. As if it were a signal, all teachers rushed over to her. She's going to jump. I could hear Kyosuke's voice. Why we have suddenly amazing music? What is going on? What is this episode? They were all too agitated by now. Masato tackled a few teachers down, but it was too late. I believe that to Koshiki-san, Inosuke appeared as if she was being hunted down by everyone. She took a step behind, even though there was nothing there. I was pushed down to the ground by someone. Amidst the scene, I saw a shadowy leap over the fence. Kengo. What the fuck? Oh wow! He jumped for her. Oh, what the... Okay, we are not on the road. We have date again. What the hell was that? Kengo is MVP. I hope he's alright. He basically fall down with her and try to protect her with his own body from the fall. Oh my god. Good job, Kengo, but I hope you're alright. At least you are not, like, mortally injured or something. Oh, what if he cannot practice kendo anymore? Oh, fuck. From one thing, it would be sad and very bad that he have to, like... He cannot practice kendo anymore because of what happens. But on the other hand, it will help Koishiki. And they will be, like, similar in the sense, you know, they both lose something. They would understand each other even more. Wow. As if blown away by the strong gust of wind, everyone fell down on the ground. Kyosuke and Masato alone clashed to the fence. Bewildered, I unsteadily got to my feet. What happened? I asked them, looking to their box. You came here too. Kyosuke beckoned me with his hand. Is there a scene of despair waiting for me down there? This fear assailed me for a moment, but their dumbfounded expressions told me it wasn't so. I leaned against my fence. I looked below, and there was the back of a male student kneeling down. He was embracing Koshiki-san, protecting her. He set her body down gently and held out his right hand to us, giving a thumbs up. What is this episode? I did not expect stuff like that happening in Little Busters, really. I was afraid. Wow. I thought like this episode will be full funny. With playing around and everything. But that's not the case. What? All my strength left me at once. Also, Kengo, what the hell do you mean that it was like already at control? What was that supposed to happen? I don't get it. Can someone please explain this to me? What he meant in the classroom? I really don't get what he meant. And then that male student, Kengo, collapsed. The checkup at the hospital was over in the blink of an eye. Also, this is the soundtrack that YouTube hates the most. I literally had to give up on masking music in Code Road at the end of the Code Road because of a lot of that thing. This is amazing music. This is an amazing song, but YouTube hate this. Koishiki-san wasn't harmed. Right now, that Koishiki-san and also me, Kyosuke and Masato were in the Kengo's room. Kengo was lying on his bed. His left hand was in plaster cast. Both of his legs were alright, which would only be thanks to his extraordinary athletic ability. That arm he protected Koishiki-san with was the only thing that received damage. He won't be able to practice kendo. I was right. Fuck. Maybe. Hope so. The one who saved her was Kengo. But the Kendo Club advisor didn't forgive him. He banned him from participating in club activities for the entire term. Even when other teachers tried to back Kengo up, he didn't budge. Most likely, on his way to the rooftop, he had to knock Endo-sensei down too. Oh, having done the very same thing, we couldn't say anything in his defense. The atmosphere was heavy. Kyosuke should have said something to redeem the situation, but he kept quiet.
約束してくれ。
ケン君はどう？
あんな真似をしないことを。
はい。絶対しません。宮沢さんが拾ってくれた命です。宮沢さんが捨てるなという限り。
別に恩を着せてるわけじゃない。古式は古式らしく生きてくれればいい。
でも
俺も俺らしく生きる。
剣道以外でですか。
古式、もし一つのことに絶望したとしてもだ。
You know what's the problem? I'm kind of emotional, and even if this whole situation was very short, and I don't really particularly feel very, very sad, but with this music, just this music makes me tearing up, you know? Because it made my, like, my thoughts going around and thinking about the situation even more, and like on the for the like future of them and everything. Music in Little Busters is amazing.
人間、やれることなんていくらだってある。それを覚えておいてくれ。
As the fifth period was over, we headed over to the sports grounds. お前、
その腕でどうすんだよ。
Also, we can't have Kengo on the baseball team now. We had him last time, right? Or not? I don't remember. I think we didn't have him on the baseball match. He was always avoiding because of the club activities.Kengo? What's at the butter box? Wait! No way! Because of the accident, he's going to train with us? Wow! Well, he still have one arm. His right hand was a bat. He spoke to Rin, who was standing on the mount.As if provoking her.
打てたとしてもその腕じゃ全力で走れないだろうが。
ホームランを打てばいいだけだろう。
ダスロー。
え？
来い、リン。
He repeated, piercing her with his glare. She knows that. She looks great in this pose. Brunette had a serious expression. Should pitch without holding back.She made a huge swing and threw it. She turned around to follow the ball with her eyes. It disappeared into the hill overgrown with greenery. Yeah. He's a monster. Masato stood dumbfounded. He tossed the bat away and started walking along the diamond-shaped field slowly. Yeah, pretty much.
Hebo nano ka? Atashi wa hebo pitcher nano ka?
I understand your shock, but your opponent was just too much.
Teoi no ogata rookie arawaru
ka? I wonder if by doing this, he's trying to prove that there's many reasons one can find to live. Wow. Koishiki can see this.And find something else that she can do with one eye. Something fun, something that she can aim for. Wow. I didn't expect it. Oh wow. I didn't expect that baseball minigame to be so important for the story. Only Rin's voice resounded across the field.Well, we still have classes. Kengo obtained titled Wounded Lion. That fits. Kengo joined the practice. Wow. Wow, that was great. The experiment went by as if nothing happened. But I couldn't shake off this thought. Was that all according to Kyosuke's scenario as well? I remember what he said during the morning. Oh. I don't think that's what he meant. And I looked at Kengo. At that time, what did I think? That Kengo, who devoted himself wholeheartedly to Kendo and firmly refused to play baseball so far, would not change his mind now. But he did, didn't he? An accident that no one could predict happened. I felt a slight chill. How far did his grasp on us extend? Or perhaps it was just me who connected the outcome to the swords. What if that accident didn't happen? Kengo didn't hurt. Didn't change his mind, and nothing else happened. Let's see on status. Yeah, we still have one place. We still don't have Mio. Mio was last one, right? She was like introduced as a manager, basically, at the first. Is it the same order that we are getting them on the team? I don't remember. You can let me know in the comments if we are getting the members in the same order. Also, Code is so cute. What if Kyosuke never put too much meaning in his words and I simply noticed something that he said and that coincidentally turned into reality? Standing at my side was Kengo. I'm done yet. You mean a bat? What's up with that? I was bewildered. Him holding a bat in his hand was too much bizarre of a spectacle. That's right, he joined the team. I finally remembered. Don't go bring the bat to the classroom at least. That's not something he would normally do, right? I felt the confusion one more time. Masato, who was looking back at me, got up. Okay. Where's your new candle? He pointed with his bat at Masato Joe. No. She blurted out, looking at his face from the side. For some reason, he burst out laughing. Wow. He swung the bat onto his shoulder and left the classroom like that. This is great. Huh. I couldn't comprehend it either. Was that really Kengo? It was such a drastic change, as if some screws had come loose in his head. I don't think he always had it in him, but it's like he suddenly switched into top gear and opened up completely. Holy shit, we're going to get a fight. Masato went running after him. It wasn't about fighting probably, but about baseball. Okay. Don't worry about that, you have me. That scene was somehow very soothing. Nostalgic. It's just like the old days. Baseball is great. If it has the power to bring these days back. This is what I suddenly thought. Are we going to have practice now? And there is Mio. Welcome back, Mio. And welcome to the team. Okay. Juno-san is going to be our manager from today on. Kyosuke answered before I could say anything in her defense. One problem down. You said it last time as well. Yeah, this is basically the same as last time. He surveyed the team members with a satisfied look. The guys were talking in whispers at her own, at their own pace.
ほら、全員に通達するぞ。
Yep. Okay. Where's Kendo? Kengo, sorry. Kento Kengo. Where is he? Oh, there he is. Oh my god. I don't think I want to hit it towards Kendo, Kengo. I don't know if I will be able to. Good job, Kud. Vosemi! What does this mean? You can let me know in the comments. Please, let me know in the comments. I will probably forget about that. But I'm really interested what she just said. Like, vomisi, it was in English? Like, her English? Or it was like in Russian? I'm trying to hit this towards Kengo. I want to see how strong he can hit the ball. Because I know how strong Masato can hit the ball, but... Oh, wow! He actually did, like, grab that ball. What the hell? Wow! Kurogaya, that was pretty far for you to go that way. I'm surprised. Okay. Whoa, good job! Hey, Kurogaya is actually useful this time! Who would know? Wow! She used Polish! Okno means window! That's awesome! Finally a word I know! Okno means window. You can learn Polish in Little Busters. Okay, we need more kids on Kud then. Sorry, I had to read that. I was like... Okay, Haruka has amazing. Okay, this is amazing match already. Deviat. Okay, I don't know what that means. You can let me know. Why Haruka is so good today? What is this? Why this team is so good suddenly? Oh, there he is. That was fast. Oh, come on. Yes, that was good. Okay, this training session is great. Gatsun, Gatsun, something, something.
Mieta.
Okay.
Yosh, kokora de kyūkei ni shiyou.
Yeah, let's do this. Yeah, we have full team. Oh, okay. They were like talking, and I said that I don't want to like disturb Gartok. I probably want to just talk with each other and everything, so I'm not going to mess up with them. But yeah. Next choice when we had that, I chose to actually go to listen to them. And it was when Kurogaya basically corrupted Kud. So I wonder what will happen this time, but we're going to do this in the next episode. So next episode we'll see what they're talking about. We'll see what girls talking about during the baseball practice. And if Kurogaya still is trying to corrupt Kud. So yeah, I'm going now to try and re-record the first part of the episode. Hope it will be fine. So, yeah. That was an amazing episode. I hope you really liked that, because for me this was an amazing episode. Especially that I feel pretty good and pretty energetic. And yeah, that was great. Anyway, thank you for watching this video. Thank you for being with me, or listening to me. And I will see you in the next one. So for now, Pocket Watch is going out.